It's Chloe, also known as HD Otaku. I'm here at Crunchyroll Expo with a very, very, very special guest, Johnny Weir.
Hi.
So right now we're just going to go over a couple of questions. I know that our fam is like so excited about you, Yuri on Ice, and so that's what we're kind of here to talk about today.
Awesome.
Okay. So, very basic question. What made you decide to become a figure skater?
Wow. Well, I saw it on television. I saw figure skating on TV. I was caught up in the Nancy Kerrigan, Tanya Harding saga.
Yes.
In the 90s. I don't know how many of our viewers were even alive for that. But it was a big deal, and I was one of the people, and my family was one of the families that were just gripped by Tanya and Nancy. I watched that Olympic Games unfold, and a beautiful wisp of a thing from Ukraine named Oksana Bayul won the gold medal and beat Nancy Kerrigan.
Right.
And I fell in love with her costuming. It was pink with marabou, and she had this big, crazy, curly ponytail, and she was just so beautiful, and she jumped so high, and I just thought, I want to do that. So the first time I ever skated was actually on a frozen cornfield behind my house. I'm from the middle of nowhere in Pennsylvania, and we didn't have an ice rink, so I nailed it. Cornfield. And in some old skates, and it was kind of the year after Oksana won the Olympic Games, and it was very special. It sounds like it's made up for a movie or something that I started skating on a cornfield, but that's really
the amazing
truth.
Maybe there should be a movie sometime soon.
Yeah, who knows?
So, would you say then that your routines are inspired by more classical things or contemporary, mystical?
I try to mix it up as often as I can, but when you've been skating as long as I have,
right,
you find your style, you find your aesthetic. It's the same as anything else in life.
Sure.
I tend toward either pop divas, now I'm just touring the world and I'm performing shows, so I'm not competing, so it's a different story when you're choosing competitive music. But now I either go pop diva, I have Sia, Beyonce, Gaga, all sort of on call.
Love it.
And in addition to that, I really still love the elegant, the classics, the Beethoven, the Rachmaninoff, the elegance of classical music. I still try to, you know, do two very different sides of the spectrum. I've always wanted to skate to rap, but I just can't see it happening for me. And I stay away from sort of jazzy, bluesy things because it's just not in my heart song. Mm.
Totally understand that. Mm. So, speaking of heart songs, kind of inspiration, your story is so inspirational. I know that people watching, listening to this, and kind of making the connection between Yuri, you know, you can't help but feel like, wow, I want to do something like that. I want to be something kind of greater than myself. So
I want to be born to make history, is that what you're
saying? Yes, exactly. So how does it feel to know that this show, Yuri on Ice, was inspired partially by you and your work?
It's very flattering and humbling. As a figure skater, it's a very niche sport.
Right.
And there aren't always people following and falling in love with skating. And it's like fashion that goes in and out. And,
right,
you know, in 5 years, skating might be more popular in America, less popular in Japan. And it just jumps like that all over the world. So it really is you, yourself, and I don't know how to actually do that, but
right,
it's really all about you. And when you're out on that ice at the Olympic Games, no matter if you have the best coaches, the most supportive family, the most dedicated fans, it's you, and nobody can help you. And it's really easy to be an athlete and have that mentality that's kind of you against the world. So when Yuri on Ice came about, I watched it because Zhenya Medvedeva, she's the Russian world champion.
Right.
She's a fan of Yuri on Ice. And she tweeted at me that one of the characters, I didn't know who they were at that time, that one of the characters looked like me. So then I started to get more tweets from anime fans where it was me with the rose crown after my Olympic performance in Vancouver, and
right,
then Viktor Nikiforov with his rose crown as well. So I had to watch the show, and I thought I would be able to get away without binge-watching it.
Oh,
but
impossible,
yeah,
impossible.
Like 3 days, and it was over for me. But yeah, I was amazed at the attention to detail and also the respect that the producers and creators have for this little world that I come from.
Right.
And I became a fan, not because I'm you know, in the story, not because it's very much my story, what Yuri goes through, but the fact that it wasn't over-dramatized, it wasn't this big theatrical thing like when we see American movies about skating, they're always really crazy. And for me, the attention to detail and the respect for our craft is why I fell in love with it. And the characters are so great, and then the love story, of course.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the love story is what I'm in it for. Skating, I see that all the time. It's really, it's the love story.
Yeah, I think what's really special about Yuri on Ice, besides the love story, I mean, I can't even talk about it without getting a little emotional because I just think it's so beautiful. But I learned a lot about skating in general while watching it, so that's really cool for somebody completely outside of that world to get a really good picture of what it's genuinely like.
Right.
So that, I think, is exciting, and I hope to see a lot more of that, you know, from the creators. It's really cool.
It was very important for the skaters, too, and the skating community to get behind this anime, because, I mean, for me, anime is a completely foreign world, and I haven't always been into it. I've always known what it was. I traveled to Japan a lot, and you can't
escape it there.
You can't escape it. And, you know, for me, it was wonderful to see the outpouring of love from the whole skating community. It wasn't just me or, you know, a few isolated people. It was everyone supporting Yuri on Ice because the respect goes both ways.
Right. That's really cool and genuine, I think. Mm. So, nice. next question. So, what would you say were some of your favorite moments on the show so far?
Oh, I loved Yurio's free program at the Cup of Russia. It was a very, very special performance, and he skated so beautifully, and he overcame so much. And, you know, to skate in a home, in front of a home crowd is really hard. To give your all in front of the people that you know your friends are sitting in the stands, your parents, and that kind of thing.
It's nerve-wracking.
Yeah, sometimes it's much easier just to be in China performing.
Yeah, because then you can just go home and...
Yeah, and tell them what you want them to know. but definitely that moment. I loved the final episode when... we realized that this whole show, this whole love story, this whole thing is actually coming from Victor. And it shocked me because I hadn't even thought that that would be a thing. I thought it was for sure Yuri, and, you know, he's super happy to work with Victor, and they love each other. But to know that it was that twinkle in the eye that came from Victor, I think it's definitely my favorite.
Excuse me, guys. Yeah. I can't even think about a favorite moment to pick. There's so many. The beach scenes are what just got me so much. I just feel like, you know, as a fan of anime for decades, this is one of the first times I've watched something and really felt a true connection to the characters and what they were experiencing. It's just so real, you know, and I know that's what a lot of other Yuri fans appreciate.
Kusna!
So, speaking of which, are there any characters from the show that remind you of figure skaters that you work with personally?
Yeah, but there are little bits of different people in the characters in Yuri on Ice.
Okay.
So, I feel that in Victor Nikiforov, there is a bit of me, a little bit.
Okay.
And a lot of Yevgeny Plushenko, who is a great Russian champion, blonde mullet, you know. he's very much my dear friend, but I had always had sort of a bromance crush on him and just loved him. And I really think that somehow it's on screen now. I think that the JJ is a little bit Patrick Chan, who is a Canadian skater, multi-world champion. He's great. But some of their personality traits are similar.
Interesting.
I don't know who Yurio is. There was one skater in the past named Artur Gachinsky from Russia. And he always had that sort of really... He was the heir apparent to Plushenko.
Okay.
He also had a blonde mullet.
Huh.
He isn't really competing anymore, unfortunately. He had problems with injuries, but... his surly demeanor is very much like Yurio. And I think Yuri, I think it's me. I think there's a lot of me in Yuri, and also Yuzuru Hanyu, who's the reigning Olympic champion from Japan. I think there's a bit of each of us in him. So, yeah. I mean, yeah, I could go through the whole list because they're, you know, Otabek is very much like the skater
right.
from Kazakhstan. And what's the little one's name? Pichito, right? Where's he from?
From the Philippines.
Philippines. There's a skater that comes not from the Philippines, but it represents somewhere equally far-flung and with no skaters. And his name is Michael Christian Martinez. Wait, he represents the Philippines. Anyway, I don't know. But anyway, that there are skaters that match up to these skaters in the anime.
I think it's fun to look up the, you know, similarities and kind of make those parallels, especially since, I mean, you know, you're here.
Yeah.
So, yeah, why not? Okay, so final question for today. What do you wish to see in the next season? Which we're all dying for, by the way, if you guys are listening. Hello.
I'm waiting with bated breath for season two. But I think something I would love to see happen, and not in a mean way at all, mm-hmm. I would love to see student overtake teacher. I would like to see Yuri beat Victor in an event.
Yes.
I wish Victor the best of luck with his training, because it's going to be so hard, and it doesn't actually happen in real life, where you're competing and training a competitor of yours. It's never...
Right.
It's not a thing. It's not a real thing. So to see how they interact with one another and how they challenge one another is going to be very interesting, because it'll definitely be a bit grating on their love story.
Right. A challenge for sure.
Yeah. But I really wanted to take the opportunity, since we're finishing this, to really say how honored I am to be at Crunchyroll Expo. And something that drew me to this event, obviously, is Euro on Ice, but more so it's in the past 6 months of my life and my social media life, how welcoming and how all-encompassing the anime community is, how supportive you are of each other, no matter what your choice is. You fly your freak flags and do it so proudly, and I wish more of us could live in a happy, safe place like the anime fans. So it's a huge honor for me to be here, and I've loved it.
That's so fantastic. I know that a lot of people were super excited. Just the fact that you're here and talking to us, so thank you for taking the time out of your day.
My pleasure.
You know, and as we've demonstrated and you've seen, you know, the anime community is unlike any other.
Very powerful.
We love you guys. Yeah. All right. So, just as kind of a final goodbye, do you want to show us your favorite Yuri pose?
Oh, gosh.
All
right.
Okay.
I'll stay sitting because I can just do it with my arms.
Okay. Ooh. All right. Thank you. Bye, guys.
Bye.